And we road test new gizmos and gadgets.
We are trying to get this really rather remarkable looking remote control car into the studio, just bending it around to the left.
Who?
Coming round to the left. Round to the left. Do you want to go?
I wouldn't mind before the batteries run out.
She's in real trouble!
I'll reverse it up. There we go.
Bring it
off
back.
Off again. Tell you what, this is going to be the present to have this Christmas.
The size of the box under the tree is going to be really rather impressive.
Reverse it up.
It's just, I nearly went into the piano there.
Nearly the piano.
Here we go. This is a disaster. Oh dear.
Lean it in.
Go on.
Yeah, well, this definitely is not a remote controlled car. How could
so
it be? It's called a Carver. It is my driving. It's called a Carver, and inside there's room for two. It's a bit like being in a leather lined cockpit of a small jet aeroplane. Now, it handles like a normal car. It's got a manual gearbox, and the steering is pretty normal. But the difference is, as you can see, when it takes a corner, it bangs just like a motorbike, and it can really tilt over very low. It's hard to demonstrate in the studio. But basically, the sporty number, thanks, Si, comes complete with a detachable roof. This can come off completely. Don't worry me. So that you can drive. Oh, look, I'm stalled now. You can, oh, I haven't. I'll keep going, shall I? So you can drive when the weather's nice with the roof down. But basically, it's difficult to demonstrate in the studio. It's a bit like driving in a merry-go-round. So take a look at it driving on a real highway. Now, if you should take a Carver onto the race course, be warned, it reaches a top speed of 110 miles per hour, and that does come at a price at over £20,000. Whoo! Steep.
Lights down, please. Sorry, Connie, I didn't mean to plunge this beautiful car into darkness. Steady there, Meg, but I'm merely trying to show you that on those dark winter nights,